Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Now I know pizza was good. Inshallah, we'll start our program with the recitation of Quran. I'll request Amar Hira to come and start the program with the recitation.
But do not consider the hunting being lawful when you are in the pilgrim garb. Undoubtedly, Allah commands what He wills. O believers, do not make lawful the symbols of Allah, nor the sacred months, and nor the sacred sacrifices sent to the sacred house, and nor those being bearing signs in their neck, and nor the property and honor of those who repair to the sacred house, seeking the grace and pleasure of their Lord. And when you put off the pilgrim garb, then you may hunt. And let not the negativity of any people, as they have prevented you from the sacred mosque, incent you to commit wrong. And help each other in righteousness and piety, and help not one another in sin and transgression, and remain fearing Allah. Undoubtedly, the torment of Allah is severe. Sadaqallahu alayhi. Jazakallahu khairan.
MashaAllah, beautiful recitation. There are two parts to this program. One is, as everybody knows, that we will be appreciating our volunteers, and the second part is fundraising. So be prepared for that, inshallah. Just joking, so relax. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Solely for the prayer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected imams, our honorable volunteers, our guests, ladies and gentlemen, I greet you again with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. On behalf of Islamic Foundation of Toronto's Majlis, we have present here our President Hassan Makki, our Vice President Brother Qayyum Khan, our treasurer who is sick today couldn't join us, Brother Salahuddin, our Assistant Treasurer Qasimuddin, our Assistant Secretary Naseem Mahmood, and also on behalf of our trustees who are present, some of our present over here, Brother Mukarram Sayyid, sorry I miss him, and our trustees, Brother Abid Sayyid and Brother Hassan Makki, our Akram Makki, sorry, who are present here to join us, to appreciate and to thank everyone you. I would like to thank each and every one of you for coming out today and celebrating with us the hard work, commitment, and dedication you have put forth in making our community a better place to be. Volunteerism and community participation play an important part in building the spirit of our community. Whether you have been a long-term volunteer or recently hopped on the boat, just remember, it is people like you who form the backbone of the community and the organizations. We are the family of good, built on the concept of promoting good. Its purpose is simply to utilize our resources within our community to help champion initiatives of good, whatever form they are found. We encourage that good must be supported, promoted, and appreciated wherever it is found. This is the essence of civil and a just society and the guiding factor for the family of good. The IFT appreciates the time you take out from your busy schedules to give a helping hand to brothers and sisters in the community at large. Whether it is Qiraat competition, hot soup days, Fountain of Youth initiative, Youth Tarbiyah conference, annual appreciation dinners, Doors Open Toronto, the landscaping team, free text clinics, funeral services, Ramadan and Eid responsibilities, parking lot duties, Sunday and weekend schools, volunteering especially in the winter, and many more, and you name it. None of it is possible without your help. So go ahead, give yourself a pat at the back. It's easy to make a buck, it's a lot tougher to make a difference, and you have made a difference in life of many of the people around you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your determination and devotion. In helping others, indeed, your reward lies with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I would like to share a quote and a hadith well suited for our event. Your life is a message to the world. Make sure it is inspiring, which it is. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the dearest to Allah is the one who is the most beneficial to the people. I started my talk with this thing, solely for the prayer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will say it again once more time, solely for the prayer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah reward you and your family abundantly. Jazakumullah khairan fa ahsanul jaza. At this moment, we have few of our young volunteers who would like to share some of their experience while their time spending with IFT. I would like to invite Sister Afnan Sayyid to come and share some of her experience for a decade of volunteering at IFT. Sister Afnan Sayyid.
Some of you are here at the crack of dawn on Saturday to prepare meals for Toronto's needs. Others put in 16-hour days to see an event through from start to finish. And despite fasting for long hours themselves in Ramadan, there are many of you who make sure that everyone else is fed before you eat yourself. It's a pretty common mistake to think of volunteering as just something nice that people can do. Sure, it makes you feel great about helping, but it is so much more than that. Your work affects not only the people that walk through these premises, but the health and well-being of society at large. I came across this quote, and I would like to say it's also very timely considering that the elections are happening tomorrow. Volunteering is the ultimate exercise in democracy. You vote in elections once a year, but when you volunteer, you vote every day about the kind of community you want to live in. Working alongside many of you, what I have witnessed is great generosity, selflessness, and care. In our world, plagued with problems, negativity, and uncertainty, there is one constant, and that is the consistent kindness and spirit of giving that comes from individuals such as yourselves. So I ask that you continue. Continue to be kind, selfless, and caring, and help in shaping our community and our common future. Jazakallah, thank you.
Thank you, Fran. At this stage, I would like to invite one of our Ufas, the person who have memorized the Holy Quran at Foundation, and now, mashallah, he is an international figure. Last year, last Ramadan, he was invited for a Taraweeh prayer to be led in the United States, and mashallah, entire month he was there on behalf of Foundation, leading Taraweeh prayers and Jummah prayers over there. Ladies and gentlemen, please. At this moment, I would like to request Hasib to come and say a few words for his experience at the Islamic Foundation.
Respected brothers and sisters, elders and friends, fellow volunteers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The first point that I actually had written down, when I was writing this, I thought I should start by saying something like, I feel honored to be honored, because I've been a volunteer here for so long, but I felt that was so monotone until I actually got here. When I came here, I sat down, I saw the vice president, the trustee, board members that are walking around making sure everyone's gotten their food, everyone's gotten their drinks. We had one of the trustees, I was walking around just asking people, hey, do you want some Coke, do you want some Pepsi? And to be honest, it feels amazing, and I say this from the very depths of my heart, that it really feels honored to be honored. And I really feel amazing. Many of us here, actually most of us here, actually, we've been here for some time, or we joined the IFT team recently. We've been volunteering. And I don't like always saying I or you, but I think we're all on the same page here when we say I and you, because alhamdulillah, we're all volunteers. Whether it was the Qiraat al-Quran competition, whether it was the Youth Tarbiyah conference, whether it's the tax clinic, the landscaping team, I can go on. Brother Waris mentioned a lot of the volunteer projects, and he still didn't finish the list because mashallah, Foundation has been doing so much. But one thing that we all have in common is that we're serving the community. That's one thing that we all have in common, whatever project that we're all involved in. And me personally, it's been such an amazing experience because, you know, we didn't need a dinner to feel honored, because many of our elders, the people higher up, our supervisors, you know, they've always made us feel really good. We've always had moments where, you know, we've experienced moments that were very tense, time-sensitive moments that where we just shared a laugh. I remember there were so many times where things like, you know, working as one of the volunteers in the Qiraat competition under Qari Yunus, if we mess something up sometimes, we'd like pray to God that, okay, I hope Qari Yunus does not walk by right now. Or I remember when we were growing up, we used to see Brother Ashraf or someone walk by the hallway and say, oh my God, hi, he's gonna tell us to do some work. But alhamdulillah, you know, growing up, I really feel this love, like a genuine love, not only to Foundation, not only to my supervisors and people that I personally work with, but every single person that I worked alongside. And just one thing that I wanted to mention is, especially for the youngsters, because I am a youngster myself, is that whether we are here to, you know, whether we're here for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake, whether we're here just to have fun, or we need volunteer hours, or we need some type of experience, what brings us together is that at the end of the day, what we're doing is actually helping the community. And subhanAllah, I've been here since I was a kid, I've seen so many differences, so much difference in the community through all the projects that have been happening, and this is the prophetic example. This is the example that our Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, had set for us. And one thing I want to mention for us youngsters especially is when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to some reports, was around the age of 20, he was involved in an association or a pact called Hilful Fudul. And that was, it was a bunch of people that gathered in Mecca. There had, you know, long story short, there were many incidents that took place, many injustices that have been taking place in the city of Mecca. And so somebody made the call that this has to stop. And as a 20-year-old, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace and blessings be upon him, stood up, and he was one of the youngest people that took part in that association. So civic engagement, community involvement, serving the community is a prophetic model. It's something that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. So we have two benefits. Whether we're having fun, we're doing it for Allah, we're doing it for volunteer hours, we have two amazing benefits. One is that we see the difference in the community. We're serving the community, and at the same time, we are serving the cause of Islam, because one of the central, the fundamental themes of Islam is to serve the community. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had taught us. And this message is obviously not just for youngsters, you know, youngsters like Brother Waris Malik, but for everybody, because this is our Prophet. He was a youngster at one point. He didn't get old at one point. And so he, you know, he taught us lessons that every single people from all ages, all walks of life can learn. And I just want to end off on this one note, something that Brother Waris actually mentioned, which I loved, which I really see here within all of us, within this group, this big family, is when he said that it's easier to make a buck, but it's harder to make a change, it's harder to make a difference. And that is the role model, that is the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the essence of many of his teachings, that it is harder to make a difference, but we should never stop. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah. Thank you.
Thank you, Hans. Very well said. This is the real Islam. This is the Islam which is contributing to the Canadian mosaic. And I think this should be appreciated, and this should be commended, that this is how this society is contributing to the society. As we move forward, we are very pleased to have representation at different levels of the government over here, from federal, provincial, to the city. I would request at this stage our federal representative, Rathika, to come and say a few words to our volunteers.
Today's an afternoon of thank you, of thanks, of gratitude. And I show my gratitude every day I see a person in the community. And by saying thank you first smile. Because when you're having a bad day and a stranger smiles or a random act of kindness, it helps boost your own day. Because that smile, you don't know what the depth of the meaning it could have. I remember when I was going through a very hard time, and I had no water, I live in a building, and the water was turned off that day, so I went to the grocery store just to buy some water, and I was on the brinks of tears because I was having a very hard time. And a neighbor somebody who lives in the same building, actually, but was at the grocery store. I was struggling to carry this big bottle, four big bottles of 4 liters of water, and a neighbor helped, and that was it. It was a simple act of kindness of somebody helping me carry water. Was enough to just push me over the limit to show my gratitude, to know that even a stranger can help boost my day just a little bit. And that was just a stranger helping me with water. But all of you here in the room who are being honored today are people who have given hours upon hours upon hours to help your family. And I know everybody here at the IFT is a family, acts like a family, to help the Islamic Foundation family, but to help the larger community, because the mosque and the school is more than a mosque and a school. It's a place where, as Afnan and the other young man who just spoke mentioned, they've been here their whole lives. It's been a place where they come to socialize, it's a place where they come to network, it's a place where they come to grow and learn. And so these walls are far more than just a place of worship or just a school. It's a place where the community comes together. And I've been able to witness that many times. And the one initiative that I had fun working with and I wish to do more with is the soup kitchen, because of all the fancy equipment you have in the kitchen. Anybody who's volunteered with the soup kitchen knows all the fancy equipment you have in the kitchen, and I don't get to use any of that at home. And I have fun helping. And that's the thing, volunteerism doesn't have to be boring. It's as long as you know you're giving from the heart, even a monotonous task, a boring task of cutting vegetables can be fun. And when you're doing it with other people from the community who want to, and you're there having fun together, it really makes a difference. And you're making a difference in the lives of so many. And in the case of the soup kitchen, so many strangers. People in the community who just need that one smile, or that one bowl of soup, or one sandwich, whatever it might be. I know I don't have too much time, so I want to say thank you to everybody here today, and I want to leave you with a quote. The author is unknown, and it's interesting that the author is unknown. And the author says, if you want to touch the past, touch a rock. If you want to touch the present, touch a flower. And if you want to touch the future, touch a life. And that is what you all in this room are doing. You are touching lives day in and day out. So I want to say thank you to all of you from the bottom of my heart. And I did bring with me a certificate from Parliament for the Islamic Foundation, and I'll present it to Brother Morris. It reads, it's a certificate of appreciation to the Islamic Foundation of Toronto. I'm hosting your volunteer appreciation luncheon today. Volunteers, you commit many hours of their days to help make sure that the community works together as a team. When members of the community put forth their effort and time to help an organization, they are teaching other members of the community about the importance of community development. I would like to thank every individual who volunteers at the Islamic Foundation of Toronto for the hard work and dedication you put forth to make this such a successful foundation. I would like to wish all of you the best in all of your future endeavors. It's signed by myself, Radhika Sitsavaisi, Member of Parliament for right here in Scarborough Rouge River. But I do present it to you on behalf of our leader, Thomas Mulcair, and I know that I have the confidence of the entire New Democrat Caucus in Ottawa to present this to the IFT on behalf of the entire team in Ottawa. Thank you so much, everybody, and hope you enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
Request the President to come and receive on behalf of the opposition. Somebody, please.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik alayhi wa sallam. Dear respected guests, Imam, and very, very respected volunteers who have devoted a lot of time towards serving the Islamic Foundation, serving the community, and in effect made the functions here all the time very successful, very peaceful, and praiseworthy. I say on my behalf and on behalf of Majlis Shura, that is the Board of Directors, and on behalf of the Board of Trustees, and on behalf of the whole of the community, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I thank our sister Rathika, who is an MP sitting in Ottawa, and she has presented to Islamic Foundation this certificate of appreciation. And it reads, on hosting your volunteer appreciation lunch, volunteers commit many hours of their day to help make sure that the community works together as a team. When members of the community put forth their time to help an organization, they are teaching other members of the community about the importance of community development. I would like to thank every individual who volunteers at the Islamic Foundation of Toronto for the hard work and dedication you put forth to make this such a successful foundation. I would like to wish you all the best in all your future endeavors. And I would add to that, Ameen. This, in fact, is a prayer. So, from all of us, from Islamic Foundation of Toronto, all the members, all the volunteers, the Majlis Shura, the trustees, and myself, I thank our sister Rathika, who has presented this to us. And I said to her, Jazakumullah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, reward you in a very handsome way. Okay? Can you see Amin? Okay. I would like to also wish everyone today, being the first of Muharram, a very happy new year. This is for our guests who do not know, today is the first of the new year of Islamic calendar. And it also happened that yesterday was the new year of the Hindu community, Hinduism, and new year yesterday. And I believe even the Jewish community had the new year either yesterday or today. So we are all following this lunar calendar system, and once in 3 or 4 years we come to celebrate our New Year's. Okay, everyone, thank you very much for bearing with me. Jazakallah, wassalamu alaikum.
So I came back up here because I was like, I forgot to say something. It was to wish you all a happy new year, Muharram Mubarak, and then now he stole my thunder. President stole my thunder. So Muharram Mubarak to everybody on behalf of me. Thank you.
the Islamic Foundation once more, because I consider this almost like home. So if I could say, Mr. President, all the members of the Board of Directors, the trustees of the foundation and the school, and my respected Imam, Imam Badat, my pleasure to see you here again. I just want to say to all the folks that do volunteer work around the foundation, congratulations for being recognized today, but Brother Waris put it very well, that if you don't nurture those who volunteer around the foundation, then the foundation itself is not successful in doing what it's supposed to do, which is build that strong community. And let me say that, you know, I've had the privilege of being at the foundation over the last 26 years that I've been elected. And I've had the opportunity to work with the foundation board over those 26 years. And I want to congratulate the foundation, because from its beginnings back 26 years ago to today, the things you're doing, you did not do 26 years ago, which says that the community is growing, which says that the foundation is doing the job that is required within the community to nurture that community and make it stronger. I remember when the soup kitchen was started, and it was something new for everyone at the foundation. Today, it's a huge success. I remember when you got the school started, and I've had the opportunity to visit the school many times, and I've also had the opportunity that some of the young men and women from the school has served at the legislature at Pages. And I will tell you that when they do have that opportunity to be at the legislature, they represent you and the community very well, because I get the privilege to have lunch with them when they're there. And we get an hour to dialogue with each other. And it's been great to talk to these young men and women and to see how positive they are and how well-groomed they are to succeed in society. So I want to congratulate all of you for the work that you do here. And on behalf of Premier Kathleen Wynne, who is currently in China, and all my colleagues for the work you do. And I want to thank you personally from the bottom of my heart. You know, I just came through an election, and today is the first day I've had the opportunity to speak to all of you. I want to say thank you personally from the bottom of my heart for giving me that privilege to serve you once again at Queen's Park. Because without you, I would not have that chance. I would not have had the opportunity to serve the community myself. And I really take that very seriously, that we have to work with each other to continue to build this part of the city. I hope the MC would give me the opportunity to say a couple more words. I see Mr. John Torrey here in our audience, and John, welcome to the foundation. But I want to tell you, John will be up here later, and I've had the opportunity to work with John at Queen's Park. He was on the other side of the legislature. But I want to say to you, he's here in front of you today, looking for your support. And I want to tell you that John is a gentleman. He's a genuine, caring person. I've had many opportunities to talk to him, and he's always been respectful and understands that all of us could have different values, but we could still work with each other. But I want to say to you something before, because tomorrow is voting day. I've traveled the U.S. quite often in the last little while. And many in the U.S., the minute you say that you're from Toronto, the only thing they could remember is the negative effect of our previous mayor. And that's not what our city needs to have as the recognition. I want to also say to you, I've had the opportunity to work with this child. And I remember, and I'll never forget, that many years ago, when I was first elected to Scarborough Council, we were committed to winning the Olympic bid. And her husband and the community downtown stopped that bid, and we were the front runners at the time. As you go to vote on Monday, I want to remind you, that in July next year, we in Toronto and in Ontario have the opportunity to speak to the world when we open the Panama gates. And when you go to vote, I want you to choose between the three people that are running and who is best to represent us. To cut that ribbon and say to the world, Toronto is the place you want to be and that we are a world-class city. I will tell you that I support John and I wish him best on Monday, but I think we need to think about what we're doing on Monday when we go to vote for the next mayor because we need to change our image. Thank you very much and I really appreciate that. Congratulations again to all the volunteers. Continue to do the good work you're doing at the foundation.
Thank you, boss. And now our city representative, Mr. Chinley, I will request you to come and say a few words. Mr. Chinley. Mr. Chinley, can you please come and say a few words? Mr. Chinley is our councillor for this ward.
Thank you very much for inviting me to your celebration. And as a councillor for this area for the last 8 years, it's my privilege to come to your mosque at various occasions to either fundraise or to help others. And I echo Mr. Barberson's sentiments that volunteerism is very important, not only to your organization, to the Islamic Foundation, to every organization that is successful. The volunteers that they have is what makes those organizations and your organization very successful. The ability to build for the future depends much on your volunteers. So tomorrow is election day. I hope that I count on your support and your vote. And I'm going to say a couple of words as well about Mr. John Tory, who is running for mayor. Back in April, I did meet with him. And I also met with the other candidates, and I know Mr. Ford as well. And immediately after my chat with him, I said, you got my support. The reason why, because I felt that he cares about Toronto. And he's going to help build Toronto. The face of the mayor of Toronto is the face that Toronto brings to the rest of the world, and to our partners at various levels of government, and to the people of Toronto. And I believe that John Tory is a face we want to place at the front of all of us in Toronto. That's why I support him. That's why I even put money where my mouth is. I even donated to his campaign. If you read the papers today, I saw my name there. I said, oh, you know, I'm very surprised by only donated $40, by the way. Not a huge amount, all right? But, you know, this is the first time I ever donated to a mayoral candidate. And I think that he's the best person for it. You know, because if each of us, even a million people, voters, okay, donate $10, that's $10 million. So, you know, you gotta put your money where your mouth is. Not just, you know, the efforts I've been endorsing him, I've been going out to put signs up for him. I've been going out to knocking doors for him. So I believe that he will make the best mayor for Toronto. So thank you very much and Happy New Year.
Thank you, Mr. Chinley. Before we move forward, I have a very important message for our representative at federal level, Radhika, our representative at provincial level, Bas, and representation at city level. This is a message I am giving on behalf of all of you and the entire community of Toronto and even Canada. I will request you that when you sit in that parliament, either you do it by a motion or by a bill, that you bring this to the attention of the Canadian government and Canadian community, that they should take out two words out of the dictionaries. One thing is, they shouldn't call Muslim terrorist or Islamic terrorist. This word there is no such word which is related to any religion like this. And wins the mayor race, I will request to them also that when you come into that office, make sure that council, make sure that Queen Park, make sure that party chair, that if any media or any representative of the federal government uses this word, tell them that this has nothing to do with the revolution. So please, whatever way you can do it, we expect that this will be done on behalf of all the community. It is very important. And I'm not doing it as a political speech, I'm doing it as a genuine concern for the community, because none of the community is target based on religion. And why our community is the only one. So please. At this stage, I would also like to clarify that the Islamic Foundation is a charitable organization, and we are have a charitable status. We don't endorse any party, any candidate, but we do one thing, we encourage one thing, which was said in Friday's sermon, that we do encourage civic participation and also go out and vote. It is your right to decide who you want to vote. It is a powerful right. You should read the manifesto of all the candidates, whether it is for the mayoral candidate, whether it is for the councillor. You should read for each one of them, and you should decide who you want to vote. It is a valuable power you have to make decision the how your city, how your country should be governed. So I encourage each and every one of you that please go out and vote. At this stage, I am pleased and we are very honored that Mr. John Tory is here with us, and I will ask him to come and say a few words, please.
Assalamu alaikum. Muharram Mubarak, and Happy New Year to one and all, to the directors, to the respective imams, and most importantly today, of course, to all the volunteers. I just want you to know how happy I am to be back here at the Nugget Mosque. I've been here many times, and I'm going to just mention briefly some of the things that I've seen when I've been here, but mostly what I've seen is, of course, a commitment to community. Commitment to faith, yes, of course, it's a mosque, but it's a commitment to community, and there's a lot more that goes on here, as I mentioned, the school, the soup kitchen, and many, many other things. I just want to mention that I have brought today some members of my family, and I'm very pleased to be with you. My wife, Barb, is here, my sister, Jennifer Tory, and my son, George Tory, is here somewhere. There he is, right there. And I bring them as often as I can to the mosque, but I certainly remember the first time, maybe 11 or 12 years ago, I brought them to the mosque with me, because I had been to several mosques in the course of my own public life. And I thought it was very important that the members of my family, at that time my father was still alive, my mother, my sister, my brother, my children, our children, we brought, and Barb, of course, with me. And I brought them because I wanted to see what I had seen, which is I wanted them to see that the Islamic faith was so much about service to community. And that's what you're here celebrating today, that you have served the community, you've served your own community, but you've served the broader community as well. The soup kitchen program isn't just about helping people of the Islamic faith, it's about helping people of all creeds and all religions, all skin colors and all backgrounds and all nationalities, and I think it's an important story to be told in this city and in this country. Similarly, I went to the Muslim Welfare Center a couple of months ago and I helped them to make sandwiches. Now, I'm not sure how good my sandwiches were that I was making, because the people who normally did it were better than me. But what was interesting to me was that those sandwiches were not being made even for disadvantaged people in the Muslim community in Toronto. They were being made for people downtown who were homeless, and the sandwiches were taken every Saturday downtown to help other people. That is what this community has been about, that is what this mosque has been about, and it's been proven week after week after week. And so I just want to say thank you, because I know that's the purpose of today's event, is to say thank you to those people who have given their time, and who have been true to their own values, who have exemplified that part of the Islamic faith that says you give back, that you sacrifice, that you help others. And I just want to encourage you to continue to do that. In my own life, it has been the most important, most rewarding work that I have done. It's my volunteer work, which has taken up a big part of my time for many, many years. And I just hope that all of you who do it will continue to do it, because it reflects well on you. It builds a stronger, fairer, more caring community, and it reflects well on your faith. So I thank you very much for having me here for this few minutes today. Thank you very much.
We also have a candidate who's running for councillor in this ward, for the Ghulam. If you want to come and say a few words, please.
Assalamu name is Ghulam Mohammed. I'm running for Ward 42 Council. Let me just thank the volunteers because they are doing a terribly good job. They're doing exceptionally good job. And as I said, as the other people have already said, that those the community grows if the volunteer grows. And if the volunteers put their effort, I think we'll do very well. Now, what I want to do is, what I want to say is that it is important that we participate in our election, whether you vote for me or not. It is important that you participate and count your vote. Make sure that it is important. All right, and I want to thank once again the organization, the Islamic Foundation, for doing a good job, and Brother Waris for inviting me here, and I want to thank you all for listening to me. Thank you. Another thing, let me thank Brother Waris to bring out this issue of Muslim terrorists and Islamic terrorists. There is no such thing, and I want all the level of government to be ready to remove that word from the vocabulary. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I just want to let you know that we invited all three candidates. Olivia Chow was also invited. Mr. Ford was also invited. Olivia Chow just texted us that she's on her way. So whenever she's here, we'll give her an opportunity to say a few words. I also would like to thank Tony to be back in Foundation. Tony was our 42 Division Superintendent and then moved on to be the Deputy Chief for Toronto Police and has been a very strong supporter of our community. Always he has been here, and whenever we took any initiatives at the police level, Tony has always supported us. Tony, so thank you very much for joining us today. At this stage, I would request Sheikh Bidad to come and say a few words at the closing dua for the day.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters and respected guests and most definitely volunteers, I want to thank each and every one of you for all your contribution that you continue to do and the great work that you put in for the community, for the masjid, for different fields of service that make our community much better. The Prophet of Islam, Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, said, "Man lam yashkuri nasa, lam yashkuri Allah." A person who does not thank or appreciate other human beings, then in reality they have not appreciated God Almighty, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So by thanking you, in reality we are thanking the Creator, the Lord, the Almighty, and. There was an individual that was named Safina, and someone once asked him that, how did you get this name Safina? Now in Arabic, Safina means a cargo ship. So he was a companion of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him. And whenever someone would ask him his name, he would always say, "My name is cargo ship Safina." And he would not relay his name, his actual name, which was Abdurrahman according to one narration. So people asked him that, how'd you get this name? He said, "I was honored to be given this title by the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him." And then he related his personal story. He said that we were once traveling and I made a commitment that wherever I had the opportunity to volunteer, wherever I had the opportunity to assist, to make a difference, I would move forward and do that. So we were once traveling and I saw people that it was difficult for them to carry their belongings. So I came to the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, and I asked him, "O Messenger of Allah, O Prophet, will you allow me to carry some of the luggage, some of the belongings, some of the commodities of the people that they're carrying, and it seems that they're finding it difficult?" So he took out his sheet that he was wrapped around in, And he said, put whatever you can. And the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, looked at him. He was so enthusiastic. He had so much spirit to help that the Prophet of Islam said, it's going to be difficult if you carry all of this. It's going to, you know, you won't be able to walk. So he said, no, I'm committed. I want to help the people. I want to make a difference. And the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, made a prayer for him. He said, Ihmil anta safina. He said, carry whatever you could, and I'm making a prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the Almighty, that Allah will give you the strength and the stamina to continue. And he said himself, that day, Safina said himself, that day, if there were 2 loads of camels, 3 loads of camels, 6 loads of camels, 7 loads of camels put upon me, I would not have felt anything because the Prophet made a prayer for me. And it is this statement that the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, when he saw him carrying that, he said, it's as though you are a cargo ship. It's as though you are a safina. And this is why he felt it an honor that the Prophet of Islam, the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, alluded to this title of safina. And this is why he felt it an honor to be called safina. So each and every one of you are like the safina, are like the cargo ship. You carry the community forward, you make a difference, and when a person gives his wealth or time or their creative ideas, they give whatever they can. This is a symbol, this is a testimony that you want to make a positive difference within the community. So we pray that God Almighty bless each and every one of you for your great contribution. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with the best. And we want to see you more often. And the initiatives are plenty. And when you continue, inshallah, we will see our community growing. Despite the challenges, be confident that when we make a positive difference, we are making a great contribution to the betterment of our communities, our society, our city, our province, and our great country, Canada. Thank you. Jazakallah khair.
Before we make a closing block, there are some individuals and some organization available to thank. The event of today has been, mashallah, there are many people who have really thanked you in different ways. The food today is donated, so they have thanked you in that way. It is from Effie Premium Grills, Patna Kebab, Silver Spoon, and Sabro Italian Pizza, which is a new place in Centenary, and it's all halal pizza and halal items. So they have, to say their thank you, they have donated on this food to say thank you from their behalf to all the volunteers. Sister Zulaika, mashallah, has donated all these flowers which you see in front of your table and everything. So she has sent her thank you on behalf of her husband and her team and her family to say it to all the volunteers. Mrs. Khan has done all the decoration for you. So she came up early in the morning to make sure that it looks like a real thank you to everybody over here. And one thank you which we have to do, and we should appreciate them and give a big applause, is this one. Sister Jamila, Brother Shaquille, Sayyid Abdu, Ashraf Khan, and their team. They have been here since morning, mashallah, doing all their setup what you see today. So give them a big hand of applause. In closing, inshallah, today we, the board of directors, all who are sitting today, will be serving you. So I request all the board of directors to be on the serving tables now, because we will start the food as soon as we do the closing of the wine.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يا الله Lord Almighty bless our community and our gathering here. يا الله, we appreciate all the bounties and the blessings that you continue to shower upon us. يا الله, these are great brothers, sisters and community members that make a great difference. يا الله, you bless them and their families, bless them in their work. Ya Allah, bless them in their wealth and prosperity. Ya Allah, bless them with guidance and goodness in this world as well as the everlasting life in the hereafter. Ya Allah, your Prophet showed us the way to work towards building communities and bringing peace, tranquility, and goodness. Ya Allah, we follow this path of the Prophet, peace and blessings upon him, so that we continue in all ways to make a positive difference with our time, our wealth, our health, and our being. Ya Allah, accept our supplication and bless us in our communities and in our great country, Canada. Keep us all safe and prosperous, and remove the difficulties of all those who suffer wherever they may be. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ إِنَّا نَسْأَلُكَ مِنْ كُلِّ خَيْرِ مَا سَأَلَكَ مِنْهُ نَبِيُّكَ وَعَبْدُكَ مُحَمَّدٌ صلى الله عليه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
As we connect with each other, thank you so much for your support.